Welcome to my channel, friends. I am on with a top five list, quickly here, of my favorite fantasy novels. And I'm going to start it off with number one, the absolutely epic The Mists of Avalon by Marion Zimmer Bradley. This book is an Arthurian legend. It's a retelling of the King Arthur tale from the feminine perspective, primarily from the Lady of the Lake's perspective, Morgaine. This book is so awesome because of the scope and depth and complexity and nuance of the plot. The book is a massive 876-page paperback, and I loved this book because of the fact that there are so many themes addressed here and so many characters and so many incidences of imagination with Marion Zimmer Bradley in this book. This is the best Arthurian tale that I have ever read. And it's the only book in and of itself that I've read that I actually view to be epic. Number two, Gardens of the Moon by Stephen Erickson. This book is truly the epitome of an epic fantasy story. As it opens up, we're thrown into the middle of a massive war. The Malazan Empire is taking over the Seven Cities. And what I really love about this story is that it is not the typical good versus evil fantasy tale. It's really hard to tell what the motives are for so many of the characters in this book. There's so much going on with different factions fighting for their own personal reasons, and the gods are involved in the human affairs. This is truly a unique and deeply imaginative fantasy tale. There's so much going on with mages and magic and traveling to other dimensions. It's a really massive in scope fantasy tale, and it really is a must read. Number three, A Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin. This book is all about the characters. It's about loyalty and betrayal and tough decision making. In this book, several families are at war with one another in the kingdom of Westeros, and they're fighting for ultimate power. This is truly a bloody fantasy novel. I really like the inventiveness and the imagination of George R.R. Martin in this book. This book has won so many awards, and it inspired the television show. The characters in this book are really beloved, and I love the fact that there's so much going on here with the subplots involved, and it's a really fantastic tale that's weaved together here by George R.R. Martin that is absolutely worthy of all the attention that it's received over the years. Number four, friends, The Drawing of the Three by Stephen King. I loved this book because it's the most imaginative book that I have ever read. The Dark Tower series is all about a cowboy on the search for the Dark Tower. And he doesn't know why, but he has to get there. And he befriends people along the way. And he kills people along the way. And he kills people that he befriends along the way. This is an incredible, not typical, high fantasy tale by Stephen King. In this one, the gunslinger is on a beach, time traveling through doors to different universes on his search for the Dark Tower. Incredibly, incredibly imaginative book here by Stephen King. I guess I'm recommending the whole series with this one. I absolutely loved this book, and it's just fantastic beyond words. And finally, friends, we have made it to the end. Number five, please bear with me, The Clan of the Cave Bear by Jean Aoul. This is a fantastic novel about a little girl named Ayla who is a Cro-Magnon woman about 80,000 years ago, and she goes and lives with a group of Neanderthal people in their cave, and she's different from them, And this is all about their lives. It's a drama. This is actually book one in a 6-book series. And the whole time I was reading it, I kept thinking, anyone who loves an epic fantasy series would absolutely love this book. The Neanderthal clan's lives are very complex. Friendships and enemies and rituals. I absolutely loved this book. It was almost a tearjerker. I was so invested in Ayla's case in this book. That's it, friends. My top five. I'm actually kind of new to the genre. I want to read The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. If you have any recommendations for me on the fantasy, epic fantasy side, drop it in the comments. Please subscribe to me if you made it this far. See you later, friends.